to put this in context a little bit, you know, Darwin comes along with the theory of evolution by natural selection, but he didn't know about genes, much less DNA. And then we figured out that there were genes, and Mendel and others, although there's a history of who paid attention to who. And then we figured out there was DNA and you know, they coded for proteins, et cetera. So I take it, you're going to correct me if I'm crazy here, that there was this picture that the things that were being selected on by the forces of natural selection were these genes that were coding for protein. And maybe the evo-devo story changes that a little bit, because the genes that switch on the other genes are equally or more important.
Yeah, and it's the switches themselves. So I think that's a true history. And I think, you know, part of the way science grows is, as you well document, is that, you know, sometimes things are just not within our reach, you know, let alone our grasp. And things were outside of Darwin's reach, and things were outside the reach of, you know, early 20th century biologists. And really, until we could clone DNA, until we could look at individual genes and say, okay, here's a gene. And in the case of the fruit fly, the sort of the genes that launched 1,000 postdocs are these genes that, when mutated, for example, transform the antennae of the fruit fly into legs, or give the flies a second set of wings. And when you see these striking, you know, appearances, and you say, you know, how can you do that? And it's a single, you've altered a single gene. It's just, you know, you're just too damn curious. You're just like, I got to figure out what's going on. And I was one of those postdocs. When I learned about these mutations that could change body parts like that, I said, well, you know, what the heck kind of gene is under there? And that when we dug into those things and had the tools finally by the late 70s, early 80s to analyze the DNA that was the genes themselves, as opposed to just studying genes, sort of what's called kind of beanbag genetics, of just studying formal genetics by crossing, you know, one fly to another. That's when we really could get at these questions. And when we did, you know, the science, you know, flourished in an amazing way.